Did you hear that?
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
Hello?
Hey, hold on. I heard something down in the basement.
Go.
Who's down there?
Oh, shit.
Something just said get out.
They're very angry, and it kind of seems like they're bent on revenge.
For several years, the story of Mary Roff and Lurancy Vennum has attracted paranormal researchers from all across the country.
I was feeling a presence right behind me, you know, a lot of energy that wasn't happy because we weren't following through with our deal.
Making the city of Watseka, Illinois and the Roff Home a hotbed for paranormal research. My team and I traveled to Watseka to visit the grave of Mary Roff and pay our respects before our investigation of the Roff Home. For many years, Mary Roff suffered from violent fits and seizures, leaving many to believe Mary was insane. Soon, Mary developed an odd fascination with blood and began cutting herself, saying she had to bleed the evil out of her. On July 5th, 1865, at the age of 18, Mary died alone in her sleep.
Mary went through a really rough time when she was alive, which is, I think, why she came back to help Lurancy, who I think was going to, my personal belief is, have the same affliction as Mary. And for whatever reason, she was drawn to her to help her.
At the age of 12, Lurancy Vennum, another young girl in Watseka, began suffering fits similar to Mary's. And that's when Lurancy says the spirit started to visit her. Claiming the spirit of Mary Roff had taken over her body. Although Lurancy didn't suffer the same fate as Mary, she would take her story to the grave when she passed away in 1928. Through our research, we strongly believe that Mr. and Mrs. Roff were heavily involved with spiritualism after the passing of their daughter, Mary. Could this be the reason the Roff Home is now plagued with unexplained activity? After speaking with so many eyewitnesses to the activity at the Roff Home, my team and I have a better understanding on how to approach this case.
Been there probably a dozen times, and there's been videotape where my equipment just started clicking as I was in the room, Mary's room.
Okay, so we're getting ready to leave the cemetery. We just checked out Mary Roff's grave, and we're gonna head over to the Roff Home and get started with our investigation. What's the buzz around town as far as?
There's some believers, some not. Just like anything else, when you're dealing with paranormal, you're gonna have some people that believe and some that don't. And if you're open to it, they'll let you know. If you're not, they're not gonna hear anything. They're not gonna see anything. And if you're completely closed mind about it, it's not gonna happen. Oh, I'll take a family table, of course.
There you go. That's
all right.
Where we're at. Where are we at?
Thank you.
You're welcome. Yeah.
What's that?
Where are we at?
Watseka Family Restaurant.
Watseka Family Table.
Yeah.
Not restaurant, table.
So right now we're at the Roff Home here in Watseka, Illinois. And we are standing in Lurancy Vennum's bedroom. She was here, I think, for 100 days. So we're going to start our investigation in here, do an EVP session, and see if we can't get her to communicate with us.
I interacted with a little girl, possibly 5 to 6 years old in the crib room, which is upstairs in the mother's bedroom. So I'm sitting on the ledge there and I felt something like fingers on my ankles. So I looked underneath me with the flashlight and there wasn't nothing there. Then all of a sudden I felt something standing in front of me. Since then I have interacted with the little girl. I've seen her numerous times since, her energy. And there's also something not really nice up there, that when he is out and about, the little girl is nowhere to be found.
The whole time that she was here, they believe that she was possessed by several different spirits. We've got a journal right here that's got when he was here doing the investigation back in 1878, basically all the questions he asked her and all the different names.
Who's he?
Dr. Stevens. He was a spiritualist and he came over, I think he was from Wisconsin, is that right?
Yes.
And he came in here and did the initial investigation when they believed that Lurancy was possessed. She would go into fits, like seizure fits, and then she would start talking in different voices and things like that. So, and of course, Mary Roff was also, they believe, possessed. It got so bad with her where she would take knives and cut herself up. She eventually was committed to the Peoria State Hospital, and I believe that's where she expired. Lurancy, if for some reason you're still in this house, could you give us a sign and let us know if you're in here with us right now? None of this equipment can hurt you. We're from Ohio. We're just here to do an investigation tonight and see if we can communicate with you.
Sounds like a demon.
If you're in this room with us, give us a sign.
Is there a spirit in here that possessed anybody, former owners?
See, even though Mary Roff wasn't in this house, you know, because they moved here shortly after she had passed away. I wonder if her spirit, because she had to come back here because she was the one that was, you know, supposedly possessed Lurancy. Lurancy, are you in here with us? Please knock on something and give us a sign. Your footsteps.
Mm-hmm. Hearing voices.
I heard the footsteps.
Are you walking towards us? They say no.
Hear something.
Did you just hear that?
Yeah.
Laughing.
You know, they knew everything about her, so couldn't they have possessed her and made her do everything and push it off to be Mary so nobody would have came in and...
I don't think so. I think whatever it was with Lurancy, when Mary came in, it was truly Mary trying to communicate with her family. But my thing is, what the hell possessed Mary?
I'm following him down the stairs and I can visually see him lunge forward and someone had give him a little push down the stairs. I was the last one to leave the room, and as I walked up, I had flip-flops on due to the weather, and it was like someone steps on the back of your foot and it kind of throws you forward. I felt that almost in the same place where Rick had been pushed going into the basement. And that's something that I just can't explain.
Well, it had to be Mary because Lurancy knew too much about Mary's likes and dislikes and things they've done in the past as a family, places they'd been.
Did you hear that?
Mm-hmm. I heard something.
Well, yes.
What'd it say?
I can't make them out. It sounds just so...
Did you just hear that? The woman's voice?
That was the woman's voice.
Can you make out what it's saying, Greg? That one don't sound slow, but like Rocky said, it sounds so faint.
Well, this sounds like a faint, drawled out sentence or word.
Lurancy, is that you that just called out Greg's name? Please give us a sign as loud as you can right now.
If there's anybody in here, can you just give us a sign? Let us know that you're here.
You can leave your light on, Rocky. It may look bright on the screen, but when I put it in the computer, it actually looks pretty good. Yeah. Is somebody from the Roff family in here with us? Knock on something. You hear footsteps? Rocky?
Mm-hmm. I heard something out in the hall. It sounded real faint though, like a walking.
That's what I keep hearing. Let me turn this thing on for a second. Just to see if we can get.
I thought you had it on. I was going to ask a question about it. So right now we're going to go ahead and turn the baby monitor on. We actually have it sitting downstairs on the fireplace, which earlier we heard a couple things coming through it, so we'll see if we got any voices down there.
If there's anybody in the house besides the four of us, do what you can do to communicate with us right now. Please do it louder for us if you're trying to communicate. Do you like having us here?
Did you hear that
growling? Growling?
Huh?
Did you hear growling?
It wasn't a growling, it was like a male voice, but a little muffled.
Yeah, it sounded like it freaking came pretty close over in this area. I heard it too.
Please do it louder for us if you're trying to communicate.
Do you hear that? Do you hear that? Do you hear that?
Mary showed herself to me almost immediately when I came here, so that was kind of fun. I was coming out of the bathroom upstairs and she was standing right there for me. And that was the same night I was pushed on the stairs, and I won't go down those stairs anymore. In Lurancy's room, or Mary's room, coming through there, I was about to walk up into the hallway and I was violently pushed back into the room. Religious objects seemed to disappear here. A lot of rosaries and stuff like that I've heard gone missing. And I was here when a couple people lost a rosary. That was my last trip here. I just started snapping pictures, and that's when I got some of the pole lights and trying to figure out where those came from, and then was drawn over to the corner of the yard because, you know, it was almost like I was being called by name there. Who's upstairs?
People say that they see dark shadows, get their hair pulled. Can you slam a door? What are you guys doing? That was a... What are you guys doing? That was a... They went downstairs.
Hey, there's somebody downstairs.
Somebody just ran downstairs.
There's a door open.
Let's go.
Open. Who's down here? Hello? Hey, John, you down here?
I get a lot of, I've heard a lot of growls. Not even, just with my own ears down there. I've heard a man in my ear. He's like, get out.
Hello?
Somebody just slammed a door. And we heard somebody walking through the house. So it's either something paranormal or there's somebody in here with us right now.
We've heard footsteps many times. What sounds like a door opening.
The door ain't squeak. Hold on, stop. Come here, and John. Shut that door down. That one don't even squeak. The other one squeak. Back here and check this door.
That's good.
Whatever work. Door it was, it's squeak. Try it. Hold on, stop.
What?
Okay, good. That's it.
Hello?
Day one of this house being built, it has invited a lot of spirits into this home.
Come on, give me a light.
Here, hold on, stop. I gotta turn it on.
Take this, take this. Go. Hello? Go back out this way. Somebody's here.
John!
After seeing that the owner of the Roff home was several hundred feet away from the house during this unexplained event, it is unclear at this time what may have opened the door and walked through the house.
Right now we're gonna head out to the field. John, the owner's out here. We need to talk to him, make sure, double check, make sure nobody came in the house while we was upstairs. Anybody here come in the house?
No. I mean, we've been out there.
Yeah, that door opened.
Open and closed, and then we heard footsteps.
Yeah, somebody ran through the house. Like, we could probably stop that and play it back, because we heard it all through the baby monitor.
So you think it was so you think somebody's in the house now?
I mean,
but look how dark it is. Like,
that's what I'm saying. Somebody opened that door. And
it wasn't the front door because it didn't
squeak.
It
was this back door because it squeaked. I mean, we could probably play it back on here and hear mm-hmm. it squeaking plain as day. We was right above that room and it was so weird because you heard the door open and close and then you hear the footsteps. And I mean, you hear the squeak, and that's why we checked the front door, but it don't squeak. So we came to the back door, it squeaks. So either somebody came in or it was paranormal, one of the two.
Because that one's got more of a slam to it than what I heard.
Yeah, this one slammed.
That's what it was.
Yeah, it was loud. I swear I heard a squeak, though. I mean, it's not saying it couldn't have, this one couldn't have squeaked.
Right.
I mean, we just heard a squeak come out of it.
It would be one thing, it was the door, but then the footsteps to follow it.
Yeah, I mean, there was footsteps
on the wood.
Wood.
to follow it after. That's why we thought somebody came in the house. So.
Well, then that's the thing. Like, did they walk in and then walk out?
No, they
I didn't hear
that. They walked in.
Nobody walked out.
Nobody went out.
I mean, the only way to go from here is in the basement. Because
which one's the basement?
Go around the corner.
Yeah.
Just keep going.
Well, I don't want to walk in with somebody. No.
Something like that?
No.
That kind of squeaking?
So that was more of a hollow.
We're gonna bring this out.
Wait, hold on, did you hear that?
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
Hello?
Hey, we're gonna bring this
Wait,
out.
Hold on, did you hear that?
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
Hello?
Hey, we're gonna bring this
Wait,
out.
Hold on, did you hear that?
Yeah.
What the hell was that?
Hello? Hey, hold on, I heard something down in the basement.
Go, go,
Who's
go, go.
Who's down there?
Go.
Come on, get down here. What the hell was that? You guys hear that down here? Holy crap, that's freaking loud as hell. Josh, get up here.
He had got orphans and kept them down in the basement.
Some just said, get out. I was standing right by the basement.
So we've always got quite a few strikes and hits in questioning and reactions by venturing to questions of what he did to those orphans.
So we're sitting upstairs, we're trying to figure out why in the hell this door slammed. We're not understanding, we heard footsteps after. We get a hold of John, trying to figure out where the shit's coming from, trying to figure out if there's somebody in this house with us or if it is paranormal. So we're heading down to the basement to figure out maybe somebody ran down the basement. And as we're sitting there, we hear something, which I ain't even positive what exactly was. And then next thing I know, from the basement, coming up, loud as hell, it says, get out!
You heard
like,
that voice,
holy
didn't you?
Shit. Yes, yeah.
What the hell was that?
I'm telling you, I heard that plain as day from this basement. But we heard that whatever it was before, and then it was just like right in my freaking ear coming. Because I was standing facing you this way, and it was just right here. That's why I wanted to get down here. And I mean, there ain't nobody here.
Did you walk all the way around?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
If somebody came in the house and walked on the wooden floors. They were all out, all the way out
See,
in that corner.
See, while you was down here questioning, I'm standing by the baby monitor, and I heard you outside talking to him, asking if comes someone come in, and I heard a voice come through the baby monitor. And I was thinking that he was already talking to him, then he goes, John, he said, did someone come in here? And that was, he said that after I heard the voice, so evidently you wasn't up to him yet.
Holy crap. I'll tell you what, whatever the hell said get out, that was loud as hell.
Yeah, that voice we heard right before we came down here.
Holy shit, yeah. That was freaking loud. I mean, plain as freaking day in my ear. So I was standing right here and we heard something. I couldn't even make out that first thing we heard.
When we talk to him, we expect to be answered. And I think he picks up on that. And I've had quite a few interactions with him.
I just try to treat it with respect. And whoever's here, I think the house has almost a personality of its own.
Yeah, see, I couldn't make out the first thing. I mean, I heard something, but then that second time, holy crap.
I mean, thought it said something like, hey, you, or something like that.
That first one?
Yeah.
See, I couldn't hardly make it out. I mean, I heard it, heard something. I mean, just like upstairs, we've been hearing a female's voice, but it's been so faint that you couldn't even hear it. It's whatever it is. It's either up here, I mean, it's like it's...
It well, while it's active, does. Let's just get going.
That door was freaking loud.
And on the baby monitor, which is down here, we heard a door slam and then something would come running through the house. So when me and Sean came down here, the only door that we figured that it sounded like was the front door. So we've now got all the doors locked. You can see here, everything's locked, even back this way. This door's locked. Front door, it's got a latch on the other door, so it's locked. And then the back door's locked. whatever we heard right here, I mean, that was loud as shit. Like, they were standing right there with us. Where do you want to go, back upstairs?
Yeah. Oh, well, I'm a little freaked out now. I'm not hearing that damn thing screaming in my freaking ear.
Did you hear that breathing? Something
yeah,
goes.
I didn't hear it.
Something goes.
Okay, let's go.
Are you down in this area with us? If that was you, give us a sign right now. Daniel, are you in the house with us right now? What if that's an aggressive spirit that everybody was talking to in the basement?
Who wanted me to get out? Or was you talking to all of us? Are you mad because we locked all the doors?
Wouldn't you think a ghost would just go through the freaking wall?
I don't understand that.
That was, I thought, at first I thought Greg went down and went out.
I don't know. I thought them two came down to, maybe Greg went out to smoke.
And then we came, went in there, and then Greg and Rocky standing right there, and then they're...
They're out, way out in the freaking field.
Yeah.
Freaking bright. You know, 200 feet or more.
And nothing could have got out without us hearing it when we were down here. We heard it.
Come in.
Wait. Go to the kitchen. We heard it come in, but nothing leave. So it's still in.
What the hell was that? Walk back there. Shh.
I got goosebumps. Stop. Just everybody come in here and just stop for a second. Whatever it's in, whatever it is, I think it's in here. Because I came in here and just immediately got goosebumps.
Josh, move it. Or Rocky.
Just stand over here. The shit we heard down here. Holy shit. That voice right there, I mean, that was plain as freaking day, like they were standing right there with us. Daniel, do something for us right now, please.
What's the reference to Daniel?
Several different groups that's been here, they've picked up either through EVPs or through mediums, Daniel, which is the more aggressive spirit in the basement. And that's where I think
here,
he
Josh,
is.
Just stay here for a minute. Let them do something. We need to stop moving for a second.
But whatever's aggressive here, and that's what they believe. You know, several reports of...
Did you hear that? Sound like something like slid. Or something like pulling something across wood.
Daniel, are you getting aggravated because we're speaking about you? We got some dishes here in the kitchen. Can you move one of those for us? Show us that you have the strength to do something.
I've only put my hands on a Ouija board once in my life, and within seconds of us all doing that, a ball came flying out through a doorway from a room where there was no one in there. And it was whipped out and it hit, you know, I don't know if it hit a person, I can't remember, but we all took off from there and we never touched that thing again. It was, I won't touch them.
Yeah, you got a haunted house that had several different possessions. You know, 135 years ago or whatever, still has activity, but now there's a Ouija board in the house. That can't help things.
One of my concerns or concepts is the Roths, or Roths, actually become spiritualists to contact her, correct?
Yeah.
They didn't say how long, or what was the period between the death and the possession of...
It's like 12 or 13 years.
It was 12 something.
So it's hard telling what they could have drawled up trying to communicate with her then, you know, in this house.
And whatever, you know, whatever possessed Mary Roff could have possessed her too.
Well, yeah, it's a good possibility, but I was still leaning toward the communication.
Did you hear that?
Huh?
Specker with you?
The communication.
Did you hear that?
Huh?
Specker with you?
The communication.
Did you hear that?
Huh?
Specker with you?
I heard it right freaking behind me.
That's what I said. Specker with you?
Sound like a freaking moaning.
That's sound like footsteps.
I heard moaning right behind me.
That's a car, correct?
Yeah.
Yeah, that's a car.
We're here to try to find answers tonight. If you could help us in any way, provide us with the answers that we're looking for. Yeah, I think just to come in and try to focus on Mary or Lurancy or, you know, something to do with that story might be underestimating who's here or what's here. I mean, especially you got
something off.
You got a freaking Ouija board in the room next to us.
You want me to go touch it?
Can we film it?
Yeah, I mean, who knows? You may be pissing something off saying, hey,
walk
I'm
in.
Here.
Let's walk in there.
We planned on staying the night, but we couldn't. There was no way. So I said, we have to come up with a game plan. And we sat down and thought about it. We're like, okay, we'll go upstairs. And we went to the man's bedroom that's upstairs and sat on the bed and started talking. And something pulled on her shirt and then pulled on my shirt. I picked up this paper that said seance, and it was some creepy stuff, you know. And I read it, and I didn't think anything would happen, and something pulled on my shirt again. So I picked up my Bible that I brought because I knew, like, he said there was, like, devil things in here, and I know that I don't want that in me or to go home with me. So I started walking away with it, and something pulled on my Bible, which freaked me out. And I said, girl, we gotta go. We blew out the candles and took off running, and that's what happened.
You know what we should do is put it on a letter and just leave it and see if it moves at all.
I think you ought to carry it down to the basement.
No. Or I think Rocky's right. Let's head down to the basement. Good idea, Rocky. Wait. Is that one of you guys? Wait. Is that one of you guys?
I asked her if she gives him permission to do something. So she stood in the middle of the room, gave him permission, and as soon as she gave him permission, her nose started bleeding. And she said her head just felt like somebody was squeezing it.
He was speaking with Lurancy. He asked her, he said, when do the spirits come? And it's almost like every night on clockwork, the spirits came to her at midnight. So I'm wondering at midnight if the activity might, you know, pick up or something. Because if they were coming to this house every night to enter her and possess her, it's possible. I mean, if that's what she said. In the Journal of Dr. Stevens, Lurancy claims that the spirits would visit her every night at midnight. My team and I will head back upstairs to Lurancy's room and test this theory. Is it possible this time noted in the journal is key to communication with the spirits at the Roff home? It's after midnight. Are the spirits here now? Did you hear that?
Yeah.
Are you downstairs? I command the spirit that possessed Mary Roff or Lurancy Vennum to show yourself right now.
What the hell is that? Oh shit.
Josh.
Josh, I'll get out of there. I'll get the hell out of there. Holy shit. Let's go downstairs. Josh, we're heading down. Holy crap. I don't know, it's freaking loud as hell, but then the freaking baby monitor went and started going doing that.
I don't know what that was. Get back in there.
Please, go back in the bathroom again, Josh.
Yeah.
Okay. Go ahead and the camera will do this time. Me and Josh are off, go get back.
Wait.
Shh, shh, shh.
Something just said something in the bathroom.
Did you hear that?
There's a girl coming up in the monitor.
Although it is hard to pinpoint a certain spirit still haunting the Roff home, I strongly believe with the evidence captured along with the eyewitness testimony, whatever haunts the home seems to be very intelligent and eager to communicate. Key to unlocking the mystery of this case, I believe, will be to figure out who or what possessed Mary Roff in the beginning. Lurancy Vennum could have very easily suffered the same fate as Mary, had Mary's spirit not come back from the grave to free Lurancy's body from possession, linking the two Watseka girls together forever in history.